Hello everyone, welcome to IMLab. I am Sam Dutto and today in this video I am going to tell you how you can connect your HTML form with Node.js and MongoDB. So let's get started. So before looking to this project, so before you have to know about how you can create your server with Node.js. So I have and also how to get started with MongoDB. So I have already made those two videos. You can check out. I will provide the link in the description below. So now first, let's understand about the MVC structure. So MVC basically stands for Model View Controller. So this is the basic architecture, how the backend works. Okay, so this is one of the architecture, how the backend works. Okay, so if the user interacts, with the view, okay, then it alerts the controller for particular event with the views what the views requested for. Okay, then the controller controls all the logic and then it alerts the model that it has changed and also updated the model. Okay, and the model is directly connected to the database. Whenever something changes by the controller, then it directly model first checks that the check for the validation. Okay, then it updates the database, and after that, then it directly alerts the view that it has changed. Okay, and then this is how the MVC structure works. So now let's see this with a practical example. Okay, and do our project. So in this project, I am going to create a form. Which I'm going to connect with Node.js and MongoDB. Okay, for backend purpose. So for that, first of all, what you need? So you need the MVC architecture. So first of all, you need the views. So create a folder named views, routes, and model and controllers. Okay, and a config folder for all the configuration parts. So here I've written the db.js. So here I'm going to connect the database. Okay. So for that, I have to write here the code for database connectivity, here for the controller, here for the model, and this for the router. Cool. And this is view. So I have already written the index.html file. So if I run this with my live server, you can see this is the sign up form. Okay. This is the name where you have to write your name, then email address, then password. Then after submitting this, it will save the data in the database model that is in the MongoDB. Okay. And then it will response back another page which is success.html. So this is the success.html signed up successfully. After clicking the submit button, it will redirect this page to the sign up page, the sign up successful page. Okay. So now turn off the live server. Now, first of all, so I have used here Bootstrap, okay, for styling. And this is my input name. Then this is my email. This is for the password input. And this is for the button. Okay. And here I have written the, I've written all this in a form. Okay. And action is /user/signup. Okay. So this is basically the route where my request occurs. Okay, and this is the post request. So my post request occurs in the backend with this route /user/signup, and this is the successful HTML page. Okay, signed up successfully as you can see here. Okay, so now we have to write the server part. Okay, so for that, first of all, what we need to install some packages. So this is the package.json file, as you can see here. Start node server.js. Okay. So first of all, we need some packages which will be appear in this dependency. npm install express. Okay, for server, MongoDB, for database, and body parser. Cool. So install this first of all. With one word, so one more thing what you have to install is Mongoose. Okay. For the database purpose. So we are going to use here Mongoose instead of MongoDB. Okay. Which is same as the MongoDB. But it's easy to implement. Okay. So as you can see here, this body parts are Express, MongoDB, and Mongoose. All the four packages, all the four dependencies have got installed. Now I'm going to write here the server code. Okay, so first of all, var express equals to require express. Then after that, body parser, include body parser here also. Require body parser. Okay, cool. Now what you need, so for now here, write app quit var, take a variable as app and initialize the Express server. Okay, cool. Now app dot use body parser dot json for requesting the body, what you have write in the body. Okay, basically for post request you need to mention this one also. Okay, app dot use, then pass body parser dot json as a middleware. Okay, now what you need, now I am going to view the static pages. Okay, so for that I have to write here app dot use express dot static and the folder name where my HTML files are present, so that is view. Okay, so this is basically for viewing the static pages. Okay, now I am going to use here app dot use body parser dot url encoded and extended true. Okay, cool. Now I have to write here the post request for sign up and then the success page and view the view index page and then here view the success page. Now in the last I'm going to listen my server at port 3000. I'm going to use here pat arrow function. Okay, so now console log here, server is listening at port 3000. Okay, cool. So okay, so here also now write the view index file, index.html file. So for that you have to write app.get, because you want to get the get, you want to use your get request, you have to use. So app.get slash route will be slash and then the callback function. So request and response as two parameters. And now here write res.redirect index.html file. So so what is this purpose? So basically I have written this so that whenever I get request the slash route, okay, so this will redirect to the index.html file. So one more thing that you can see here that I have not mentioned the real path, okay, or the relative path. that slash view slash index.html, because I've already mentioned here the app.views express.static views means whatever the files present in the views folder will be your static page, okay, viewed as a static web page. So now npm start, okay, now search here localhost 3000. Cool. So you can see here that the sign up form, this is basically the index.html file. So if you write here slash index.html, you can also see this page. See, same thing, right? Only this, that the whenever you click this route in slash route, then it will redirect this page to the slash index.html page. Okay, that's why this route comes into action. Okay, now for viewing the success page, sorry, you don't have to view here. Okay, let's do that to app.get. So basically here app.get slash then request response and res dot so here you have to write the res dot redirect success wait sorry wrong spelling success dot html. So here also same goes, that you can see here that the it is already in the views folder, that's a static page. Okay, save this file, again run the server. Okay, one more thing you have to do for not again and again start the server. Okay, it will whenever you change something here, it will automatically take that, okay, and restart the server. So for that I am going to install node 1. So let's, okay, install. Okay, already installed. So as you can see here in package.json, node 1, cool. So one more script right here, start div, okay, and right here node 1 server.js. Now go to this server.js file and okay, so first of all write a npm run dev, sorry, start this, okay. So as you can see here that it is whenever something changes, if then it will restart the server. Okay, cool. Now I have to write here the post request. Okay, so for that I'm going to use this user router.js file. Okay, because this will look nice. Okay, that's fine. App.post, right here the path. I'm going to write here user. As you know that here the post action will be slash user slash sign up. That's why I'm writing your user, and the sign up I will add there in the user router.js file. Okay, cool. So slash user, right here user router. And one more thing, what you have to do here, variable user router equals to require dot slash in the router folder, so routes folder in slash user router. Okay. Now go to the userrouter.js file and write here the code for getting the route. Okay. So in my case, I only want to get the post request route. Okay. So first of all, here also requires express. Then constant router equals to express dot router. Okay. Now what we have to do? Now here router. So this is basically I've used this for write all the router. So this is basically one feature of Express. Okay, you can modularize this router in this way. So this is quite cool, right? So here my router dot post. Okay, and then okay here first try router dot router route and write the class post. Sorry, sign up. Then dot post and write here the controller. Okay, so here you can also write the routes code. Okay, but I want to more modularize this, that's why I write here in the user controller.js. So here write the path. Okay, so first include that. So where, okay, first create this. Okay, here. So I've already created this. Okay, let me write this again. So where user model equals to require dot dot model slash user model. Okay, so this is basically for the model. So I have to write that. So before that, okay, first of all, let's write the model here. Okay. So where Mongoose require mongoose. Now what now here write schema. Okay, user schema, and here write mongoose dot schema. And first field is for name, okay, of type string. Now second one is the email of type, this is also string, and add some validation here that this is required field, required true. Then one more unique, also true. Okay, that it must be unique. Then email, after that write here the password field and write here type of string here also, and this is also required field. Okay, so my schema is ready. Now add this to model. To create a model, for that you have to create a model of user. So take a variable user and write mongoose dot model and write here the model name user and user schema. Okay, so one more thing, you have to write the always the model name as the singular form. Okay, and first one is capital. So what the Mongoose model does, it automatically pluralize the user model name. Okay, that means it will take this as a user. Now write here model, sorry, model not, not model, module for exporting this file. Model.export equals to user. Okay, so this is my code for the Mongoose for the model. Okay, so I write there in the model folder. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to connect the MongoDB database. So for that, what you have to write, so here write the DB connectivity code. So here also I need Mongoose. So require that first of all. Require Mongoose. Now constant. Write the function. Okay. Take a function of DB connect and store this in a async function, because I want here the promise for getting the promise. You can also write here as dot next dot bin, but I want here, I want to use here async. Okay. Then I don't have to write too much code. Okay, so first of all, try catch for catching the error handling. So constant connect equals to, so await the means get the Mongoose, get the data from mongoose.connect. We have to first connect the MongoDB data, MongoDB database. So first of all, right here, so as you can see here, the mongoose.connect here, first of all, first parameter is the URL, then second the options, and last one is the callback. So because I write here in async await, I don't have to write here the callback function. My async await combination do this for me. Okay. Otherwise, you have to write here like mongoose.connect, then URL string, then some options after the dot, then this, then if that doesn't occur, then dot catch. So right here the URL. So for local MongoDB localhost, URL is mongodb/, then localhost 27017, then slash write the database name. So let's take, I want to write here that user, okay. Not user, let's take test. Okay, as my database name, and the second one is the all the options required. We use unified topology as true. So this is basically for not giving any warning. That's new use target. Second one is the use new URL parser. This one also is true. The last one is the use create index. That's true. So try always try to write these options, okay, for not giving any warning. Now this is done for my MongoDB connectivity. Now if this successfully occurs, then console log MongoDB connected. MongoDB connected at so here write them. Okay, so right here this only. So MongoDB connected. So if this code doesn't execute, okay, if any error occurs, then due to my try catch error handling, it will go to this catch and catch the error, whatever error occurs. So console log error while connecting to database. Okay. Now exit. Now write one more process dot exit. So this will exit from the server running mode. Okay, that's why right here process dot exit. Okay, that's it for DB connection. Now export. this file to module.exports db connect. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to include this. Okay, for database connectivity, so where you have to do this, you have to do this in the server file. So after the after this app equals to express, or before that, right here db connect. Okay, so as you can see here, that this is for VS Code auto completion. So as you can see here, that the constant db connect required /config/db. Okay, it will take the db connect from this file. Okay, means import this now. This done. Okay, my model is also ready. Now you have to write the user controller. So first of all, what you have to need, take a variable as the user model, then require .../model/user/model. Okay, so this will take basically this file. Okay, means this will take this model, user model. Okay, from this file. Now so now here you have to write, take a variable as constant, and let's take signup user. I have already done that, so okay, no problem. So now take here also async await. I'm going to use the async await, request, response, and arrow function. Okay, so now let's destructure. Okay, destructure the request.body. So name, first we need name, then email, then password. Okay, now right here request.body. So this will take all the data from the body as name, email, and password. Okay, so basically this will take from this index.html file whatever name you have write. So here you can see here I write the name as name, then name as email, then here name as password. Okay, cool. So this will take this data. So now what you have to do, let's try catch here also for error handling. Okay, so first write this error for error. So race.status code is 404. If error occurs, then race dot send. Okay, error. If error occurs, then it will send the error to the HTML file. Okay, cool. Now what you have to write here? So you have to write here constant, take a variable as user, constant variable. Okay, and then await user model, means create the data to the database. Okay, so for that you have to write here user model dot create. So this is basically a promise. Okay, this will return, this will not return, this will take a new data, this will add new data to the database. Okay, MongoDB database. So right here user model dot create, then write name as name, because in my model first field is name, then second field is email. Second field is email. Okay, then third one is password field, the user model, and the password from this request.body. okay, take the value from this password. Okay, so this will do all my, so this will add all this data, name, email, and password, to my database. Okay, cool. But in real world, you don't have to write this password as this text string. Okay, you have to encode this first of all, then add this to the database, so then no one can see any user's password. This is basically for best practices. Okay, and also for better authentication. Now race dot redirect. Okay, then if this successfully occurs, then race dot redirect to /success route. Okay, and if this not successful occurs, then it will send the error, whatever error occurs, it will send that to the normal HTML page. Okay, or also you can write the, see this error here also. Okay, cool. But here you have seen that some error occurs. The route.post request requires a callback function, because in user router.js file I have not mentioned any callback. Okay, callback function. So here you have to pass that function. So right here, user. Okay, this sign up user. Okay, this is basically the controller. So as you can see, that the sign up user requires controllers dot dot slash controller slash user controller. Okay. So now what you have to do? So again, you can see once more error occurs, because you have to pass this to the main server file. And there you have to, here you have to pass this as the middleware, this one. Okay. You can see here that I have imported this, but I have not exported till now. Okay. So let's export this. Module dot export equals to what router. Okay, cool. So now if I go to the server file, there you can see that the user router is imported from that router file, user router file, and then after that here I have used this router, okay, as a middleware. So app dot post slash user is the router. And it will go to the user router, okay, for routing purposes. Now it will go to this slash sign up. That means my post route will be slash user slash sign up, right? This is basically my, basically for the router, for routes for the post, okay, post request. Here in the index.html file, here you can also see that in the form I have written action as slash user slash sign up. Okay, cool. So here you can see the server is automatically restarted whenever I change something here. So here server is listening at port 3000 and MongoDB is also successfully connected. Okay, cool. Now if I go to this file, okay, refresh this page. Here you can see that the sign up form appears. Now write here name as to one. Let's check, then let's add this one at the gmail.com, then let's add password at Shubham. Okay, now submit this data. Okay, here it is written, cannot post slash user slash sign up. Let me check this. Sorry, my bad. I have written here app.post, because you don't have to write here app.post, because you have already write that here, right? Router dot route slash the router, whatever router route, okay, you want to redirect to, and then the post. Okay, here already you have write that. So here for using that router you have to write here app dot use. Okay, so app dot use is basically a function, okay, which basically takes two parameters. First one is the router, wherever the route is, route goes to, and then the here it takes the second middleware as the router. Okay, so here you can also see that this only take the middleware. Okay, here body parser, here then express dot static, here URL encoded body parser. Yeah, that's it. And one more thing, I have done that wrong here, app dot get slash success. Okay, this is basically for the slash for getting the index.html file page, and this is basically for the success page. Okay, now we save this file, save this page. Okay, then goes to the browser. Okay, refresh the page and click on this submit button. So as you can see here, that the after automatically successfully created the data to the and add the data to the database, it will redirect to the sign up successful page. Why? Because you can see here in the user router and in the sign up user controller, here after successfully creating the data and add that to the database, it will redirect to the slash success page. Okay, which I have written here. Okay, app.get slash success, then redirect to the success.html page. and this is a static page. Okay, cool. Now, and one more thing here, open the for viewing the database, open the MongoDB Compass. Okay, first go to the local, okay, localhost 27017. Okay, then goes to this test database. As you can see here, that it automatically appears here. Okay, then click on this. Then here you can see that the collection and users is also automatically appears here in the user model. You can see here that I have written here the slash user. Okay, and it will automatically pluralize this term and write here user. Click on this, then refresh this page. Okay, cool. As you can see here that the name Shubham appears, then email, then password is user 1234. Okay, cool. So this is how the form works, and this is how you can connect your form with the MongoDB database. So thank you for watching this video, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this video.